talk about the things that strike fear, loathing, and despair into the hearts of women everywhere. Because you know what's coming up? Spring break. And you know what's after that? Summer. That can only mean one thing. It's time to go bathing suit shopping. Here are a few tips while you're picking out your suits this year. Try to avoid bathing suits that are from a catalog. Those suits don't even look good on the model, so how do you expect them to look good on you? Plus, you have to order more just to find one that fits you. It's annoying, it's aggravating. If you can, go to a store that actually just sells bathing suits, because they have people trained to help you. Sure, the sound of screaming and laughing coming from the fitting room next to you may be just a little bit disconcerting, but you really need to try on 10 suits just to get one that fits you. Remember, bathing suits, when you are buying a bathing suit, you have to order one size up from your dress size because they're all funky like that. If you're a size 10, order a size 12. You can try to get a bathing suit that won't fall apart in the hot tub or fall off when you're surfing or when you're swimming. There's really nothing more embarrassing than having to ask a stranger to hand you your bathing suit bottom if he can even find it. But I could be wrong. Don't buy one of those girdle bathing suits. They're so funny. First of all, if you're buying a girdle bathing suit, it's just going to squeeze all the fat up around your neck. And the other part of the fat is going to be squeezed out around your thighs. This is not a good look for most people. Just don't do it. Plus, this little thing I like to do called breathing. You can't do it if you're wearing a girdle bathing suit. Breathing is fun. Breathing is good. We should all breathe. Wearing a bathing suit. Try it! Don't think you need to look like a swimsuit model. Is someone paying you $250,000 to wear your bathing suit? I don't think so. Just accept the fact that you're not 20 years old, you don't have a big tan on, and you look good at what you have. So just be happy that you could even put one on to begin with. Proportionately, try to balance the top of the suit with the bottom of the suit. If you're top heavy, get something that kind of goes out at the bottom. If you're bottom heavy, get something that little bit of detail at the top. Don't buy an old lady bathing suit unless you happen to be an old lady. This is not 1928. Your suit does not have to come down to your knee. Please, your knee. Don't buy one of those bathing suits with all the bells and whistles on it. You know, the little beads that like click and clack and shiny gold lamé or silver lamé or the leopard print one. If some stranger comes up to you and says, "Nice suit," they're being sarcastic. You shouldn't have bought that suit. Last but not least, of course, I always tell people to wear jewelry, but I think necklaces with bathing suits are just not a good idea. They kind of tangled up and